Hello, and welcome back to Average Guy Reviews. I'm Noah Rustum.
And I'm Kareem Rustum.
And I know we've been off of the air for a while, but we hope to come back and bring you more episodes. But today's episode will be an interesting one, because in Average Guy Reviews, we've played a lot of games, and we noticed in shooters, the one thing that makes it is the assault rifle. So we're bringing you a top 10 list of original assault rifles. You might be wondering, what's an original assault rifle? It has to be an assault rifle that's not real world and can only appear in an original game. So M4s and M16s, you're out of luck. Now let's start the list off with number 10. Now at our number 10 spot, we have the M82 Killzone 2 Assault Rifle. Now, you might be wondering, how'd this make the list? Instead of a red dot sight, it's got a green dot sight. And instead of 30 rounds, it's got 32 rounds. No? Still doesn't cut it? Well, basically this thing is one of the most reliable weapons in the entire game. You can blaze through the single player only using the M82 and most of the online. It's highly reliable and it's the closest thing you're going to get to an M4 in the entire list. So it gets our number 10 spot.
Hey, this is Kareem with the number 9 spot for the Pulse Rifle from Dead Space. This game full of creepy critters has got some of the coolest mining weapons available. Shredding up limbs, turning aliens to chum, and shredding up limbs again. Well, one weapon stands out from the rest, and that happens to be the only assault rifle in the game. Aside from the single shot and fully automatic fire, it's got really one cool feature that stands out from the rest. The Sprinkler of Death. Hitting turret full of bullets spreading all over the room, clearing out crowds or any creepy critters that might come your way. With a cool feature like that, that secures at the number 9 spot.
Coming in at the number 8 spot is the Halo 1 Assault Rifle. Now, we specifically mentioned Halo 1 because this was the rifle packing 60 rounds and a lot of heat. Also, it had that little arrow that pointed at God knows where, but pointed at something. It was one of the most reliable rifles in the game. You could take it with you the entire single player, and also it became the face of Halo. Anytime you saw Master Chief, you always see him carrying the assault rifle. So it gives it the number 8 spot.
Coming in number 7 is the Elite Spectre Assault Rifle from Mass Effect. Captain Shepard never goes into a scenario without packing heat, and oh, does he pack heat. This assault rifle is so customizable, the footage you're seeing now is a rifle that can never overheat, vaporizes enemies, and is accurate no matter where or how fast you move. Yeah, it's that customizable. With flexibility like that, that's gotta land at the number 7 spot.
Coming in at the number 6 spot is the Swan Long Assault Rifle from Fallout 3. Other than the odd pronunciation, this is one reliable rifle. When you're running around in this post-apocalyptic future, you're gonna want a good weapon with you. From raiders, mutants, and little crab creatures and mole rats. You want a good assault rifle. And the Swan Long is perfect in every way. It has the largest assault rifle clip in the game, it's easily repairable, and also, it packs one hell of a punch. This is a rifle that's completely reliable. I know what some players might be saying, but what about the pulse rifle? What about the Telsa cannon? What about those? That's not an assault rifle. This is, and it can be taken with you throughout the entire game. An overabundance of ammo is also a helping feature. So this lands it the number 6 spot.
At number 5 spot is the Bullseye from the Resistance games. In true Insomniac fashion, this little weapon comes equipped with rounds of the intelligence of bees. Just tag any target, and the rounds will follow in and tear them apart without even you aiming or looking around the slightest corner. I'm sure the noobs will salivate over this one. This line's at the number 5 spot.
Coming in at number 4 is the Penetrator from the Fear series. This highly accurate assault rifle capable of fully automatic fire goes straight through body armor. And also, one thing that makes it very distinctive, you can nail your enemies to the wall. That's right, nothing says I own you like hanging them like a little pinata, beating them with a stick, staring at them, and maybe popping a few shots extra. This feature alone gives it the number 4 spot.
At the number 3 spot is the Combine Pulse Rifle from the Half-Life series. This expensive looking toy packs quite a punch, with great power, accuracy, and a sound to it deeper than Barry White's voice.
I've heard people say that.
And on top of that, it's got a really cool grenade launcher. It doesn't launch any regular bomb though. It launches an exploding bouncy ball of dew. Launches on any hard surface and it bounces around until it touches a soft target, vaporizing them to xenon. Catch that volleyball, Tom Cruise. With a really cool feature like that, that's gotta land at the number 3 spot.
Coming in at the number 2 spot is the Battle Rifle from the Halo series. Introduced in Halo 2 and continuing on in Halo 3. It's got the range and accuracy of a sniper rifle, the look and feel of a hot Asian woman, and the power of a shotgun. This thing has noobs craving for it as soon as a match starts, and pros going all over it. It has unbelievable capabilities, and it's awesome in online and off, taking care of any opponent in any situation. This weapon scores it the number 2 spot. Alright, here it comes. The number 1 spot. The king of all assault rifles. What could it be, Kareem?
I don't know. You tell me, Noor.
Well, it's... The Lancer, Gears of War series. This King of Rifle packs lots of ammo, lots of power, and an underbarrel chainsaw. That's right, an underbarrel chainsaw. So it always provides you one hell of a gruesome death. Oh yeah, and it's pretty accurate too.
That's right, Noor. And by the way, nothing says I love you like sodomizing your opponent with a chainsaw right up the spine. XOXO.
This is what gives it the number 1 spot. Take it away, Barry.
I've heard people say that too much of anything is not good for you, baby. But I don't know about that. There's many times that we've loved and we've shared love and made love. It doesn't seem to me like it's enough. It's just not enough for you. Just not enough. Oh, oh, man.